Good evening, guys. Hope you're enjoying your evening, and thank you for joining me at 6:28 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. There was a magnitude 2.6 earthquake along the Hayward Fault there in San Leandro, California. Many scientists believe that the Hayward Fault is one of the most dangerous faults they have there in the San Francisco Bay Area. 123 people so far have reportedly felt this magnitude 2.6. This was a strike-slip earthquake, and the fault moved north. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that 2.6. Yeah, we got an interstate over here. Let me zoom in. The red line is the Hayward Fault. Yeah, it moved north. The fault is moving north. Let me move it out for you so you can see it. Interstate 580, Redwood Heights. The areas I've drawn out in red are areas of great concern because of liquefaction if there's a large earthquake. And there's a lot of overpasses here for these interstates that would probably come down in a large earthquake. Most people talk about the San Andreas fault zone. But the Hayward Fault is actually more dangerous than the San Andreas Fault. The last major eruption for the Hayward Fault was in 1868, and it was only a magnitude 6.8. It occurred on October 21st, 1868. Known at that time as the Great San Francisco Earthquake, it violently shook San Francisco and surrounding cities, killing 30. And yet many people who live there don't know about this earthquake. They know about the 1906 earthquake, but not the 1868 earthquake. The town of Hayward at that time was almost completely destroyed, or many of the buildings had significant damage. In this article here, it says the shaking lasted more than 40 seconds. The fault lifted up 6 feet. Between 28 and 37 miles. And I'm going to make this image larger for you because this is the same location as today's earthquake. Reports about this 2.6 earthquake from EMSC state that it was a long rumble, shook the house, and scared the cats. Another one said it was a loud jolt. I was watching television. Felt like my cat went behind and hit my sofa, but my cat was still sleeping in the kitchen, and I'm in East Oakland. One person from San Leandro said it was a slight shake. Another one from San Leandro said it rumbled for 5 seconds, heard before they felt it. Golf ball rolled off the table. Another one said it shook the whole house for about 3 seconds. Waiting for a second round, I would not be surprised. Another one said they felt 2 slight bumps. So are you prepared for a large earthquake? Do you have your TV strapped to the wall? Do you have your bookcases bolted to the wall? Do you have large objects removed from the headboards or your bed where you may be sitting during a large earthquake so they don't fall on you? Do you know how to turn off your gas and water? Do you have the tools to do it where you can grab them right away? Do you have a plan where you would meet family members after an earthquake? Do they know what to do during an earthquake? Please put your comments down below, and don't forget the pets when you're preparing for a large earthquake. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.